welcome once again to Accessibly Live. I am Rich here, and you see we have some guests here in the good old studio. We have Di here. She's a regular caller, as you regular viewers might know, and she's got two guests with her. And Di, why don't you introduce your guest right here?
Okay, this is Ray.
Hello, Ray. Hi. Say hi to the folks at home there.
Hi.
And this is Lisa.
Ah, I see. And this is the first time, by the way, they are on this program. Of course, you are regular viewers. Yes, 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 yes. Say yes, just like we rehearsed it. Okay, there. Well, anyway, there are guests here today. And, of course, not only they will be taking your calls at 572-0618. That's for the people over in Columbia Heights. Remember, for all you folks out there watching out of Roseville and the surrounding suburbs, please do not call. I'm sure you know about that right now. And, of course, why don't we get into our question of the week? Oh, and by the way, and also on the program, besides having our fine studio guests here, and I use that word very well here, we're going to be featuring two movie reviews. In fact, one is a new movie that's going to be opening tomorrow. It's Don Bluth's An American Tale, the full-length animated cartoon executive produced by Mr. Spielberg, and everybody knows who Mr. Spielberg is. And also, we're going to be taking a look at a re-release of Walt Disney's Song of the South. So we got two animated features opening tomorrow. That would be on the 21st. So that's going to be later on in the program here. Well, anyway, Di, you've probably seen what the question of the week is now.
Yes, I did.
Yes. In fact, it was recently reported in Billboard magazine, the trade publication of records and whatnot, where last year, 1985, the most type of recordings sold were cassettes. The first time ever. Usually records were the number one sales item, but cassettes
they last longer.
Well, actually, yeah, they do last longer, and of course, they're a lot more smaller, they're more compatible, and of course, everybody likes to carry those large boom boxes and those portable stereos around with them, and of course, you can't do that with a turntable. So we're kind of asking out there, what type of recordings did you buy last year? Did you buy more of records, cassettes, or maybe you're getting into compact discs, those CDs, which, by the way, is really the biggest seller of this year compared to how many units were sold last year and so much and so forth like that. 5720618, and let's go on to the trivia questions here. Okay, question number one, in what city was Bazooka Bubblegum made, and actually not was, but is made? You know Bazooka with the little jokes, Bazooka
These
Joe
little
and friends?
Jokes on them, yeah.
Yes, but we want to know what city they make those little guys in. Question number two, let's punch that up. Okay, what year was the first street cleaning machine used? When was the street cleaning machine, the one we all know and love, the one that makes a large racket at 3 in the morning, when was it first used? And, of course, question number three. In fact, this is kind of a little historical question here, mainly because today is that anniversary, but what is the longest-running TV series? It did premiere on this date way back when, but we want to know what the name of the longest-running TV series is. By the way, yes, it is still on the air. 5720618, we might as well put the phone back on here now that I did my spiel. Ah, Di, this is your first opportunity to take
the
calls. Okay, why don't we punch up to the question of the week here.
Hi, Shelly.
We got Shelly on the phone here.
Good.
Apparently, Shelly must be a big fan of Di.
Remember Shelly? Remember Shelly?
Yes,
she came down here at one time?
Oh, yes, I remember.
With the glasses, and she's little, and was during the summer.
Hey, Shelly, what's happening out there? Glad you're tuning in here. By the way, why don't we punch up the question of the week, and why don't we ask her, or why don't Di ask her, by the way?
What type of recordings did you buy more of this year? Records, cassettes, or CDs?
Yeah, you could even read it right here if you want.
She didn't buy anything.
You didn't buy anything? So you're none? You're none of the above? You didn't buy any recordings?
Which,
come on.
Which more do you have at home? Records, cassettes, CDs, or none? I mean, come on now. Which record, do you have? Records,
don't lie now.
CDs. You get more tapes?
You have more cassettes,
then. She gets more cassettes.
How many cassettes do you have in your collection?
Two.
Two cassettes in your entire collection?
How about
just two? You mean not 50, not 35, but two, count them, two cassettes. Okay, well, I'll ask you this, or Di will ask you this. Di, you ask her, how many records does she own?
How many records do you own? None.
You own none, no records?
And no CDs.
No, oh, well, obviously, if she doesn't own any records, and if she doesn't own any...
But she has brothers that have lots of tapes.
Ah, how many cassettes do your brothers, it's more than one brother, okay.
Yeah.
How many cassettes do your brothers own? Well, we'll ask her that, or Di will ask her that.
A thousand?
A thousand. many? 1,000?
Yeah, they have a lot of.
You mean 1000, not 10 or 10, but 1 and 3 zeros.
Yep.
Is that 1,000? 1 and 3 zeros, right? I used to get that confused with four zeros and 3 zeros. That's true. Mm-hmm. I'm not saying I used to get confused with it recently, but then again, that's another story, and we won't get into that.
That's just have to do with phone. It just makes an interrupting sound.
Oh, are we getting some phone problems here?
Well, it just goes boop.
Boop?
Yeah, it goes
boop.
Boop.
It goes boop. Hey, remember, gang, our phones go boop here. How many live shows that you know of now
and,
out
and
there?
Remember, guys, the reason why I'm on the show is because today is my birthday.
Yes, by the way, I'm sorry. I'm glad you reminded me. Di has a birthday today. Hey, happy birthday to you. No, nobody's singing along. Yes, nobody's singing along here. Okay. Sweet 16. Today is Di's sweet 16's birthday, and she is going to be 16 for, get this, one whole year. 365 days. You count them. She's going to be 16 years old today. In fact,
it keeps on going boop.
It keeps on going boop. Well, anyway,
what's the matter?
Well, actually, we had a new phone system put on here recently. That's why, you know, the old phone with a whole bunch of buttons?
Yeah,
we kind of got rid of those, as you will. Oh, that's
really?
Why it's going boop. It's got call waiting. Remember,
call waiting,
folks.
When you push for call waiting.
I don't know how that works here. Remember, we know how to work the equipment, but we don't know how the equipment works
call
here.
Call waiting.
5720 ZigZagDean.
Tone heard. Depress switch box. Dial number 9.
Di is reading the dial off here. You see, they have little instructions
here
for
put
people
the
like.
Up for her.
Okay, put the questions up. Okay,
yeah.
Question number 1. Let's go over the questions really quick, but in case the people at home just tuned in. Okay, let's go. Come on, gang. Crack
on,
crew
guys.
Here. Let's,
come on.
Come on, crack crew. Thank you. No, okay. Question
number
1. It's on page 1 if you really want to know. Okay.
In what city is Bazooka Bubblegum made?
Okay, that's question number 1. Question number 2 is, in what year was the first
Columbia
street...
Columbia Heights, she said.
Oh, she's guessing number 1. Columbia Heights where?
Where in Columbia Heights?
No. I mean, what state?
What state?
It may not be Minnesota. You know, there is more than one Columbia Heights out there.
I'm going to try.
Do you know where
the
other Columbia Heights are?
Can I try to call waiting?
Can you try the
this
other...
This is call waiting. It says dial number 9.
Dial number 9. I don't know if that
the
works.
Answer.
Why don't you try it?
Okay, hang on, Chell.
Okay.
If
she's going to try
up,
our call
that.
Waiting here, 5720618. If you want to call us, and we're kind of experimenting with our telephones, by all means, give us a chance to have you as our guinea pig. Boy, oh boy, isn't that something there? And remember, it's not costing you a cent. Question number 2. Yes, let's go into question number 2. In what year was the first street cleaning machine used? We're not necessarily saying here in this community. We're talking about forever. But what year was that first introduced? And question number 3. Question number 3 is, what is the longest-running TV series still on the air? It was premiered on this date, November 20th.
Nope.
So that's kind of a little anniversary, of course. It is Di's, also her anniversary, if you will. And we'll get into that in a minute once she gets off the phone. If she gets off the phone, whatever. So 5720618 is our telephone number.
What?
We want to hear from you.
Is it gun
and, of course,
smoking?
Our question of the week as far as...
She thinks it's gun smoke.
What question is she answering? Gun smoke?
The longest TV series.
Oh, the longest running TV series is gun smoke? Well, we're talking about the longest running series still being produced.
What
now, gun smoke, by the way, did run
Cosby
for...
Cosby Show.
The Cosby Show? No, we're talking about not like... Well, we're actually talking about years. Cosby Show was on for what? Less than 2 years, I think it was.
Hey, Shelly, can you hang on? If I hang up on you, call back, okay? Because I'm going to hang up and then dial this 9 number and answer it.
Okay, we're just kind of testing with the phones
here.
Huh?
Thank you.
Okay.
Can you call back? Tell who?
5720618 is our telephone number.
Hi. Shelly said hi.
Yeah, Shelly says hi to these
so
people out there.
So
if
I'm
you want to say hi, 5720618. If you live out in the Roseville area and you know who
Hello?
You are, whatever
yeah,
you do, please don't call because obviously we are not on the air live, even though we would like to be, but then again, we'll keep you updated on that as time goes on. Okay, we got another phone call. Di is taking your calls at 572-5740. Apparently her fan club is calling. How come my fan club doesn't call? Well, actually, I do have a fan club here.
Grace
see,
said hi.
I brought him. Grace, hey, Grace, what's going on there? Hey, we're glad to hear. Say, Grace, while you're on, or while we have you on the air, we want to know how many or what type of... She answered the question before we had it punched up. Punch up the question so people know that's tuning in knows what's going on here. Okay, you want to answer the question. Okay, what type of recordings did you buy more of this year? We're talking about 1986, in case
you haven't... She thinks it's the Brady Bunch with the longest-running show.
Oh, you're talking about question number three as far as the longest-running TV series, the Brady Bunch?
Yeah.
Well, actually, the Brady Bunch is no longer being produced. Thank goodness. But then again, that's my opinion. But no, it's a
How about the Beaver?
The Beaver.
Leave it to Beaver.
Leave it to Beaver? Leave it, you mean like, gee, Wally? Well, even though that Leave It to Beaver is a great series and should run forever, it does not qualify to be the longest running TV series. In fact, do you know how long Leave It to Beaver ran? I'm talking about the original series, not the new Leave It to Beaver that ran on the Disney Channel and is running on Ted Turnip's Superstation, whom I will not mention, but then again, we all know what that is. Do you know how long it ran? We might as well have a little bit of studio
participation. Is it Alfred Hitchcock?
Alfred Hitchcock Presents? Mm-hmm. Is that what your guess is?
Yeah.
No, it is not Alfred Hitchcock Presents. Remember, this program is still on the air to this very day.
Hey,
I'm talking about new episodes, okay? That's what that's the qualifications.
We want to know.
We want to know.
Which did you buy more last year? Records, cassettes, or CDs?
Okay, punch up the question there, crack crew
cassettes.
Out in the studio. Cassettes?
Yeah.
How many cassettes do you own?
How many cassettes do you own?
By the way, who do we have on the air?
This is Nancy.
Hey, Nancy. Hi. Okay. So how many cassettes you own, Nancy?
Nancy owns 2,000. She's serious.
2,000?
Yeah,
you mean 2,000? Didn't we just do that?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I don't know.
Led Zeppelin.
2,000 Led Zeppelin recordings. Different recordings or the same recording?
Most of them are Led Zeppelin.
Oh, most of them are Led Zeppelin.
Yeah.
You mean like 1,998 are Led Zeppelin and the other two are miscellaneous, right?
No.
Okay, so that means 18 are Led Zeppelin. Well, that's not most of them if it's 2,000. That would mean 1,982 of them are not Led Zeppelin. Don't get smart. Okay. Unless, of course, you know, you're counting like solo performers by Jimmy Page or Robert Plant or something like that. That's Zeppelin related, but then again, that's not Zeppelin per se.
Nancy had said hi before.
Okay. Yeah, Nancy, we said hi to you, so...
Call her ugly bum. Because she wanted you to. Come on, we gotta go, because a call's waiting.
Yeah, we got a lot of calls, Nancy, so... Okay, all right.
5720-68...
We got another call? Boy, we don't even get the chance to have the phone ringing here.
Is it New Heights? New Heart?
Okay, who do we have on the air? Who do we have on the air first?
Shelly.
Oh, Shelly. A different Shelly or the same Shelly?
Same Shelly back.
Okay, the Shelly is calling back again. She's guessing the longest running TV series on the air, and she's guessing the Newhart show. Is that what she's guessing?
Is it Newhart?
I mean, I don't know. Is that what she's guessing?
Yes, yeah, she's guessing
okay.
Newhart.
She's guessing Newhart. Well, Newhart's a very good answer. Unfortunately, it's not the longest running TV show.
Is it Accessibly Live?
Is it Accessibly? Don't we wish?
Shelly, did I put you on hold?
Unfortunately, Accessibly Live does not qualify.
Hold,
however, why don't you tune in, gang, around, let's say, maybe around 2015, and then we'll classify as the longest-running TV show.
So
in the meantime, let's not hold our breath, okay? 5720-618 is our telephone number. For all you people living out in Roseville, and Al, please, whatever you do, do not call.
Call
I know I don't really want to sound like a nag, but then again,
goodbye.
I've heard from a lot of frustrated people that...
Hello, you're on the air.
We got another phone call right here. Di is taking your calls today. We have her two guests here. If you'd like, you can reintroduce yourselves to the folks at home who's just tuned in here.
Here, Rich.
Okay. Dan, we got Dan on the air. Hello, Dan. You want to answer the TV question? You're answering the question as far as what is the longest running television series still on the air to this very ding dong day? Okay, what is your answer to this fine question? Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood is the longest running series? Well, I'll tell you, believe it or not, Mr. Rogers, you know, do you realize how long Mr. Rogers has run? Do you know by any chance, just offhand? You don't know? Okay, just tell me how many years do you think he's been on the air? 15 years? Well, I'll tell you. In fact, he's been on, believe it or not, this year. We're talking about 1986. In fact, since last September, he's been on the air for, believe it or not, 19 years. Unfortunately, he does not qualify, or his program for that matter, qualify for the longest running TV series. However, he has been on the air much longer than probably a good number of his viewers on there. Okay, by the way, since we got you on the air, Dan, how many recordings are, I mean, how many, as far as the most recordings have you bought this year, either records, cassettes, or CDs?
I want to talk to that person after you get done.
Okay. You bought more CDs this year. How many CDs did you buy this year? You bought 20 CDs? You actually owned a disc player. Oh, you just got it. Just like what, last year or the year before or when? What's that? 2 months ago and you purchased 20 CDs, so that means you own more CDs than records or cassettes. Okay, well, okay, Dan, very good. Well, thanks a lot for calling, okay? Okay, thanks. 5720618.
Yeah, what's your last name?
Okay, I guess Dan is calling Di here, and by the way, we want to know. By the way, why don't you punch up the question of the week there, Crack Crew? Okay, Crack Crew, I'm sure you can hear me out here. 5720618. We want to know how many types of recordings have you purchased more of last year, either records, cassettes, or compact discs? Or maybe if you're like some people, maybe you didn't buy anything this year.
Now we're just.
Is it okay? We have someone on the line here. Yeah, who do we have on the line first of all?
Mark.
Mark. Hi, Mark.
What's your name, Mark?
You want to know what the longest running TV series is, and you're guessing MASH. Is that what you're guessing? Is Mark guessing MASH?
Is Mark
Baxter? It's my uncle.
That
are you Lisa's uncle?
We got Lisa's uncle on. Are you serious, Mark? Are you the uncle of Lisa right here? Are you or aren't you? Are you just jiving us?
No, he is.
He is?
Just
really?
Just ignore that little clicking sound.
Okay, he is then? Yes, ignore that little clicking sound for the people calling at home there, 5720618. If you do call us,
yeah, is it
call
MASH?
Okay,
it's
are you saying,
MASH.
Okay, MASH.
It's not MASH.
Are you guessing MASH is the longest running TV series?
Yeah.
Well, MASH unfortunately does not qualify for the longest running TV series. And I should say, and I'm going to stress this, that when we mean by longest running series, we're talking about it's still on the air. They're still producing programs. You can see brand new episodes. Mm-hmm. MASH, Tad, its final swan song episode, what is it, like 3.5 years ago, something like that, had a zillion people watch that great episode. I thought it was mediocre, but then again, that's my opinion. Okay, all right, we got...
there, Mark?
Why don't you put on the question of the week, Crack Crew?
Hey,
Crack Crew, okay, thank you very much. We got a Crack Crew here. Sometimes they're a little deep. If you know what I'm saying.
He buys records more.
You buy more records. How many records did you buy this year?
20.
You bought 20 records this year. Did you buy any? Did you buy any cassettes offhand this year, or any disc discs?
Just one.
You bought one. What? One cassette or one disc?
One cassette.
One cassette and how many discs? Or if provided, of
None.
Course, you own a player.
None.
And out of your collection, how much, or I should say. To put in another word here, I'll think of it. Don't worry, this is my program here. But how many types of recordings do you own the most? Do you own more records or cassettes out of the relationship of how many you've purchased this
more
year?
Records.
You own more records this year, so that means obviously you will buy more records than, let's say, cassettes or discs, providing, of course, you get around to getting a player, right?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay.
Well, then thanks, Denmark, for calling in. Call later, okay?
Okay,
thanks
for
Bye-bye.
Calling there. 5720618, if you want to call us.
Okay.
Di is
okay,
taking
yeah,
your
there.
Calls right here. And if you want to answer our question of the week, or if
TV
you
want
to try any
wants
of
TV,
our questions.
They want the TV
question. Okay, who's on the phone, first
Who
of all?
This?
We always like to know who's
Who
on the
this?
Phone there so we can say hi to them. It's no fun saying,
again?
Hello, generic
Joe?
Person. Joe. Joe's on the phone?
Joe.
Hey, Joe, what's going
what's
on there, Joe? Okay,
what
that's
is
okay. Joe is fine.
Oh, you're the other kid's brother, right?
The other kid's
oh,
brother.
Gosh.
Okay, we have the other kid's brother. So
okay,
Joe is on
TV
there.
Question.
So, okay, so he's going to get the TV question here.
Is it Sesame Street?
Are you saying Sesame Street for the longest running series still on the air? Is that correct?
Yeah.
Okay, well, Sesame Street has been on the air for a good number of years. However, it, again, does not qualify to be the longest running TV series still on the air.
Okay.
It's a very good guess, though. We're getting a lot of good guesses, I have to admit here. A lot of people are doing their homework, at least for our questions here. Okay, in the meantime, he's guessing.
He buys more CDs.
You buy more CDs?
Yeah, of the poll.
Of the poll. And how many CDs have you purchased this year?
How many CDs have you bought this year?
In relationship to records and cassettes, of course.
Five.
You bought five CDs this year.
Okay, now guess on the table.
And what about records or cassettes? Did you buy any this year? Hello? Did you?
Cassettes he bought.
You bought five CDs. Okay, five.
Two cassettes, five CDs, and how many records? Three records.
So that means you bought five CDs, three records, and two cassettes. And how many of those items do you own in your collection? That is, do you own more records?
Is it Search for Tomorrow for the TV thing?
Oh, Search for Tomorrow. Okay, he's guessing the TV question.
No,
Search
it
for Tomorrow?
No, it isn't.
How do you know?
Because I'm looking at the answers here.
Okay. That's how you know. You cheated. You looked at. But that's okay. She's not qualified. Remember, employees and guests of Accessibly Live and their immediate families are not eligible. Okay, we want to make this fair for everybody. We'll pick up the phone here. Okay, we got one of Di's guests here. Lisa is taking your calls at 5720618. That is our telephone number.
Can you hear us out there?
Yes, they can hear us out there.
Can you hear Lisa?
Yeah, just a minute. She wants to talk to you. It's Nancy. She has
We got Nancy on the phone here. Hey, Nancy, what's going on?
Is it the Honeymooners?
Is
no,
it the
it is
honeymooners?
Not.
Well, the Honeymooners, no, unfortunately, has not been in production for a good number of years, even though... Yes.
Wizard of Oz.
No, Wizard of Oz is not a TV series. That's a movie.
Can you hear me?
Sure, I think.
Can you hear me, Nancy? Can you hear Rich?
Can you hear me? Yes.
Can you hear Lisa?
I hope I'm not babbling and nobody can hear me. They
How
see
about the
my
Waltons?
Lips
no, it is not the Waltons.
It's not the Waltons. See, remember, Di
no,
knows what
little
the answer
the
is because she cheated, okay?
No, it's not
again,
good
remember,
times.
Accessibly live.
Nancy, can you hear Lisa?
And employees are not eligible. I think I already said the
can
rules.
Can you hear
there.
Lisa? When you talk to her on the phone, can you hear her out there? You can.
We're also making some mic checks out here. Remember,
okay,
we got
two
the
more
official
guesses.
Accessibly Live crack crew here
what is
doing
it?
Their duty here. By the way, Accessibly Live
no,
crack
it's
crew.
Not General Hospital.
Way to go. See, we always
no,
give
it's
credit when credit's
and
due.
And no, it's not what's
5720618 is our telephone number.
Okay.
That is our call, our number if you want to call
no,
us.
No, it's not the Jeffersons.
It's not the Jeffersons. Can we still have Nancy on the air? I don't know. We got so many people
I gotta
calling
go,
here,
Nancy,
I can't
okay?
even keep track.
Okay, call back later.
Okay.
Bye.
All right, we'll take one more phone call. We'll take one more phone call, or Di will take one more phone call, and then we'll get into our first movie review, okay? American Tail, that's the movie we'll be reviewing. It will be opening tomorrow, by the way.
It?
That is November 21st, in case you haven't looked on your calendar.
Can she know when it is?
Okay, who do we have on the phone here? Who do we have on the phone?
No, she can't know
who do we have on the phone?
Diane said I can't tell you.
No, you can't,
it's
Shelly.
Shelly.
Hey,
Shelly.
Shelly
back.
Oh, Shelly. Hello, Shelly. What's going on, Shelly? Glad
she,
you're calling
she
again, Shelly.
She said to take the presents back then. She's just kidding, though.
Oh, she said why are they taking pictures of us?
Why are they okay, the reason they're taking pictures because we're taking some publicity photos. Which, publicity photos? Well, that in case, you know, that I want to show, you know, what, you know, if someone hasn't seen the program, and they don't have access to a videotape recorder or a TV set, for that matter. They can look at a photo, and they can say, oh, that's what the program looks like. However, we will not necessarily use all those photos and things like that.
She's getting frustrated, and she says if I don't tell her the answer, she's going to take my presents back.
If we don't tell her the answer...
She's going to take my birthday presents back that she gave to me today.
Shelly, you're not going to do that, are you? Shame.
Yeah.
Shelly, you wouldn't do that to sweet little Di. Come on. This is her sweet 16th birthday. It's a big event
yes, she
for
would.
Her. And you would do that.
Yes,
Shelly,
yes,
shame, 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 and all that sort of stuff. But however, Shelly, I'll tell you this. Oh. If nobody gets the answers toward the end of the show, then we will reveal the answer, okay? So in the meantime, don't get on the warpath yet and take all those presents and things like that. Okay, yeah, why don't we, okay, and after
okay, I'll
this...
give you a clue. We'll give you a clue.
We'll give you a clue?
Okay, what does that say right there? Okay.
I'll give you a hint, gang.
It's got to do with a newspaper.
Okay, yeah, well, it's close.
Close to a newspaper.
It has to do something
Channel
with
Channel 5,
a newspaper.
She said.
It's what?
She said Channel 5 News.
Channel 5 News. Channel 5 News is, well, that's
60,
not what we
60
had
60 Minutes,
months.
She said.
Okay, Shelly,
no,
what's your answer? Is it Channel 5 News or 60 Minutes? What is it? He has to take one.
She wants me to tell her the answer.
Shelly, come on. I'm sure you've got a little patience. I mean...
No, she doesn't.
You have no patience, Shelly? Mm-mm. Shelly, I am surprised at you. I mean, you've got no patience, and you're going to threaten to take Di's presents away. Come on, I'm sure you could do better than that. What's everybody going to say? What am I going to say?
She's going to take the presents away if I don't tell her.
Well, Shelly, I tell you what.
Oh, she's kidding.
Oh, you're kidding? Are you sure?
She's kidding.
Hey, Shelly, we know you are kidding all the time. We're just trying to test you. Hey, see?
Okay, well, thanks, Shelly.
We're not that
stupid,
okay. Right? Okay.
Okay, ready?
All right.
Bye-bye.
Okay, I tell you what. Before we take our next phone call, before we take our next phone call, once I disconnect that, we're going to get into our first movie review. Of course, as you know, that starting this Christmas season, there's going to be a whole slew of brand new pictures released. I disconnected the phone because we're going to get into our first movie here. A new movie. In fact, it's a full-length animated cartoon for you animation freaks. This is going to be a real treat for you. Is a new movie that's done by Don Bluth. We're not finished, ready for the clip yet. I'll let you know. Called An American Tale. And this picture, in fact, this movie is about a family of mice that is living, that's living out in some foreign country. It takes place in the late 19th century. And, of course, they immigrate to America, where the streets are gold-plated and all that sort of stuff. Well, on the way, this family, of course, gets lost from the main character, Fievel. And, of course, they do both. They do make it to America. However, Fievel, the main character, is separated from his family, and he spends the rest of his picture looking for his family. Of course, each one of them knows that, well, of course, they're missing, but however, his family thinks that he is what they call deceased. And, of course, Fievel does run into a lot of shady characters in New York in the 1880s, and we have a clip of where he does encounter one character that apparently locks him away. And, by the way, before we get into this clip, why don't you see if you can guess who's playing the cat there, Tiger the cat. So why don't we get into that clip right now, okay, crack crew?
My name's Tiger. What's yours?
Fievel. Fievel Mousewitz.
Oh, dear. Listen, I like mice. Oh, no. Not like that. I mean, I don't eat red meat at all. I'm a vegetarian. That's right. Oh, a little fish now and then. But what I really like is some nice, broccoli.
You know, I thought all cats were supposed to be mean.
Mean? I am mean. What's the use? I like butterflies with big golden wings and blue and green tips.
Me too.
I like Swiss cheese ice cream.
Me too, me too.
You too, too? Wait a minute. What's your favorite book?
The Brothers Karamazov.
The Brothers Karamazov.
As this picture is concerned, now eventually, as far as the characters Fievel meets, he does meet a lot of more interesting characters. It's kind of like what Pinocchio did when he was on Pleasure Island. I have to admit, the plot is only mediocre. However, the animation is rich. Don Bluth used to work over at the Disney Studios years ago, and he does the type of animation that Disney did many years ago. In fact, if you're a big animation freak, I highly recommend this picture. It's a family picture. It's rated G. No violence, no cussing, no nothing. Just pure entertainment. It's going to be opening tomorrow, November 21st, at a theater near you. Check papers for showtime. Okay. All right, Dad, why don't you connect the phone back out there? And by the way, later on in the program, we're also going to be looking at a re-release of the Disney classic Song of the South. One of my all-time favorite pictures here. Okay, Di is taking your calls at 572-0618.
Yeah. People can't
make me embarrassed.
Can you move back because people can't see me?
Oh, either. I'm sorry. I'm blocking away from Di here. Okay, that is Di, by the way.
What?
Lisa is sitting right. Lisa is sitting right next to you.
That's
her,
Ray.
And Ray is sitting right over there. So now we know how it is. It's me, Rich, Di, Lisa, and Ray, or Ray, Lisa, Di, and me, depending on where you want to go, either left or right or anything like that. 572-0618 is our telephone number. We're taking your calls. You can get a chance to talk to Di.
Right here.
By the way, if you even want to ask us any questions or something like that, that is the same telephone number that you can reach us. And I should say, and I don't want to really sound like a nag, that for all the people that's living out in the Roseville area that is serviced by Group W of Roseville, whatever you do, please do not call us, okay? Just like Larry King Live, when he does some tape programs, he says the same thing, and I'm sure you can tolerate that as well.
She said to say happy birthday.
Okay, who's on the phone
Thank you, Nancy, for saying happy birthday.
Nancy, thanks for calling. I'm glad you're wishing. Di has a birthday today. It is her sweet 16th birthday. It's one of her, in fact, when you have a sweet 16th birthday, it's probably one of the best birthdays you can have. I don't know why, but that's what I've heard. Okay, 5720618. Lisa, by the way, is taking your telephone
call.
Who's on the phone, by the way, Lisa?
Huh? Who is it, Lisa?
Lisa, who's on the phone? Somebody's on the phone.
Lisa?
It's my brother, Jason.
Okay, Jason's brother, Jason, is on the phone. Hey, Jason, glad you called. By the way, Jason, while we got you on the phone here, why don't you put on the question of the week, Crack Crew? Thank you very much. What type of recordings have you purchased more of this year? CDs, not CLs. I don't know what CLs are. COs? Okay, did you buy any more COs? Tell us what COs are. I don't know. I bought about 15 last week. I always buy COs. No, seriously. What did you buy more of this year? Records, cassettes, or the compact discs? You know, the little laser discs.
He buys more cassettes.
You buy more cassettes? How many cassettes did you buy this year so far? Well?
Well, come on.
About two, he said.
You only bought two? And what about records or CDs? Did you get any of those?
What about records or CDs?
Providing, of course, you own a CD player. Obviously, if you don't, you wouldn't buy any.
No, I didn't buy any of them.
No records, no CDs, but two cassettes. And how many cassettes do you have in your collection in, let's say, relationship to records? We know you don't have any CDs, unless, of course, you do, and you haven't just bought any CDs anyway. So
about 10 or 12.
You have 10 or 12 what? Records or cassettes? You have 10 or 12 cassettes and how many records?
How many records?
You should know. You're his sister.
Yeah.
Well, I don't know. Maybe they have different musical tastes. I don't know how many records my sister owns. I don't know how many she buys. She don't tell me because I don't ask her. Okay. And by the way, she's not watching us mainly because she subscribes to a competing cable company that, at least until recently, was not in the business of making refrigerators nuclear warheads. What's a switch hook?
Yes.
What's a switch? What is it?
This?
Are you asking me trivia questions?
Yeah. No. What's this on the phone?
I don't know what that is. I don't know. It's a new telephone system we have here. We've only had this for a couple of weeks. Before, remember, we used to have the old phone with the buttons on top that lit up and, you know, kind of made, you know, like a type of sound. I know it's not accurate, but then again, I'm not an expert for sound effects. But anyway, we got a new phone system that was put on here just a couple of weeks ago. And in fact, even though this is less complex, we're still not used to it. You figure that one out. 5720618 is our telephone number. Di is our guest, by the way. Lisa and Ray.
Can you guys hear her?
Yes.
Can they hear her?
Can anyone hear us out there? By the way, if anyone can hear us.
When she talks on the phone, can you guys hear her when she talks on the phone? On the TV?
You can't hear.
Can you guys turn up the microphone?
Yes, I'm sure. Yay, we're over here.
Can you guys turn up the microphone?
Yeah, I'm sure you can. 5720618 is our telephone number.
Do they hear us on the TV?
Can you guys hear on the TV?
Can you hear this on the television set? Well, we do have a set right here. You see, we're right now here in the studio. And right over there, you can't see it, obviously, because the camera is in front of it. But we do have a monitor. And if I do turn up that monitor, you're going to get what's called feedback, which is like a high whistling noise.
Yeah.
And things like that. By the way, Dad, I guess we have another phone call. By the way, after we do have this phone call, By the way, Dad, since we are between phone calls here, tell us, why is a sweet 16 birthday so significant compared to any other years? I mean, what is the significance? And we know that when you're 18, you know, you're classified as a quote-unquote adult, where you can vote, get drafted, and all that other good stuff. But what makes 16 so significant? I never knew that.
Yes, it is.
Die. We're over
here.
Yes, wake up. Yes, wake up. Come on, morning.
Because, I just feel like when you're 16, you feel like you're getting
What's
older,
your name?
But in a way you feel good about yourself, but in a way you feel bad.
Why is 16 so significant? I mean, how come you can't feel that same way when you're 17 or 29 or 38?
Well, it's that.
What's your last name?
Boy, we really have somebody interesting on the phone right here. In fact, this person is so interesting.
Tanya.
She won't tell the last name because she doesn't want anybody to know until
That's okay.
Okay,
no,
Tanya,
we won't have
Tanya.
Any first names. We only use first names here, folks.
Tanya,
so
can you hear Lisa?
Your anonymity is guaranteed.
Can you hear?
Can you
hear her? Can you hear Ray?
I'm sure maybe the Crack Crew can turn up the mic here a little bit. Crack Crew, in case we don't get any.
Pronto.
Yes, okay. That's 5720618.
Okay, yeah, well, like I said, what's 16? Okay. You feel like you're, still feel like a little kid, but then you're getting older and you're becoming like a more an adult, and that's a good part.
I don't know
but
if
then
I
you don't want
to. Commend you for, because you wanted me to.
But you don't really feel good about yourself because
You're getting older, and you have to go out on the world on your own, and you gotta make your own bread.
Oh, no, it does that all the time.
And you're getting out of high school, and you're gonna say goodbye to your friends and all that kind of stuff. See, because you're getting older now. Now, next year, it's gonna be more worse because you're almost there, and then V2 is gonna be really worse because you're gonna be out in about a couple years.
So you feel that you're breaking away from your, I guess, you're from your childhood, if that's the proper word to use?
Yeah.
I see. But
no, you can't until it rings.
No, you can actually put the phone down on the cradle there.
It's more better though.
Oh, you like to keep your finger on the little buttons there. Okay. Yeah. Well, all right. Well. Anyway, Dad. But nonetheless, so I guess you're having a kind of like a love hate thing with.
Well, yeah, because
16.
You see, I like my childhood, but then you're getting older into adult, and then you got to go out on your own. That's what everybody has.
So you're saying this is like the beginning of the end, if you will.
Well, it's something like it, because then in two more years, one more year, I'll be an adult.
Well, do you feel that you will have the responsibilities as that an adult normally has? I mean, do you feel that you would be ready? Maybe not so much now, but let's say a year from now, or 2 years from now, or even 6 months down the road. Do you feel that you will be ready for at least certain responsibilities?
Well,
I'm sure you have some responsibilities.
I do
now,
yeah, but you see, down the road you're going to come up with more responsibilities because you're getting older, you're going to have a job. When you're on your job, you're glad to do what your boss does, unless if you you'll lose your job.
Well, it all depends basically on who you work for. I mean, there are some jobs, I can't really name any offhand, that are probably a dream, that are a dream to work with. And there's a few that I do know of, and there's even a few that I don't know of. Okay, we have someone on the phone. Who do we have on the phone?
He hung up before I could ask.
He hung up.
Oh, really?
People out there, 5720016. If you want to call us, we are asking
no,
the question
it's not
of the
Superman.
Week as far as what type of recordings did you buy more of this year, either records, cassettes, or those new compact discs. And by the way, in comparison to the other type of recordings, that is records and cassettes and discs, according to the Record Association of America, which is kind of like a non-profit organization that audits the sales of recordings and things like that, compact discs and their players increased, believe it or not, 150% compared to a year ago this time. However, that does not necessarily mean that records or even cassettes are on their way out, even though that cassettes outsold
people
records for the first time.
People, please, can you say your name? Because we want to know who you are, and we want to know who's calling.
And remember, folks.
So he wants you to say your name. Did you tell me before the show?
We're only taking first names.
He told me that before the show.
Yes, and remember,
you don't have to say your last name.
Yeah, in fact, your anonymity is guaranteed, unless, of course, you want to let us know what your last name is, and by all means, we'll reveal it. However, in case you're just a little leery,
it's your choice.
Yes, that's what it is. Remember, this is my program, not okay. 5720016. I tell you what, since we're kind of between phone calls, why don't we get into our second little movie quickie review here? Of course, Walt Disney Productions. Of course, we all know who Walt Disney Productions are. They're going to be releasing their 1946 feature, Song of the South, and of course, probably a lot of you out there have seen this picture. And in case you haven't, we even got a brief quickie clip for you, just to give you an idea what it looks like. So why don't we get into that clip right now, okay? Okay, crack crew, that's your cue. Zip, 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 zip,
zip-a-dee-doo-dah, zip-a-dee-ay. My, oh my, what a wonderful day. Plenty of sunshine heading my way. Zip-a-dee-doo-dah, zip-a-dee-ay. Mr. Bluebird's on my shoulder.
It's the truth. It's actual. Everything is satisfactory.
Zip-a-dee-doo-dah,
zip-a-dee-ay.
My, oh my, what a wonderful day. Plenty of sunshine heading my way. Zip-a-dee-doo-dah, zip-a-dee-ay. Zip-a-dee-doo-dah, zip-a-dee-ay. My, oh my, what a wonderful day. Plenty of sunshine heading my way. Zip-a-dee-doo-dah, zip-a-dee-ay.
Okay, well, anyway, that's a little bit of the brief clip of the 46 picture Song of the South. I have seen that movie something like 16, 17 years ago, and believe you me, I still remember it just like I saw it last week. It's going to be re-released starting tomorrow. In fact, it's going to give a little competition with American Tail. However, if you're really into animation, and if you're into some family entertainment, which I feel that there's not enough of, then I do recommend those two pictures, of course. It is rated G. It's going to be opening tomorrow at a theater near you. Check papers for showtimes. Okay.
This is my, this is the shirt that I got for my birthday. I'll stand up and let you see it. Guys in the back, can you get a close-up of it when I stand up? Okay.
Why'd you stand up? Let's see what's on your shirt there. What does it say out there? It says there, I can't even read it. It says...
Fonza Classical.
Fonza, what is that? That sounds
Forenza.
Like...
Forenza Classical, it is a, it's a, what?
What is it?
Aren't you embarrassed?
No, it's a name of a company that makes these things, and
they make
are,
things. What things they make? Do they make...
Styles.
They make tiles?
What styles?
Styles?
Yes.
Styles.
And they're Italian.
Well,
this is Italian.
I hope they are. I mean, I hope it's not Japanese. Can you imagine a name like...
And what? Who are you?
Oh, we have someone on the phone here. Who do we have on the phone?
Craig who?
Hey, Craig.
Craig who?
Hey, Craig, Smith. What's going on, Craig?
Do you know me, Craig Smith?
Do you know her? Are you watching this TV show?
I hope so.
Do you know me?
Do you know Diane? She's the one right there with the blue shirt on.
Remember, this is Di. Lisa's sitting right next to her. And we have Ray right over here on the,
I'm a sophomore.
That would be
yeah.
Your left, right?
No,
whatever. Well, anyway, you
yeah,
know what
I do.
We're talking about,
yeah.
Okay? You obviously, I'm not Ray, so if
really?
If I'm giving you the wrong directions, then you
Andy's
kind of
nice.
Know what's going on here.
Andy's nice.
Well, here, talk to
Andy.
Okay, while they're passing,
Yeah, I know Andy.
That's his
yeah,
brother.
Tony, I know him too.
Andy's brother?
Yeah.
This is Andy's brother on the phone, by the
yeah,
way.
Yeah, they're
5720618. If you want to call, or if your brother, sister, Uncle Louie, whatever, wants to call, that's the same number to
yeah,
do it.
Yeah, they're twins, aren't
however,
they?
However, if you are living
are you
outside of the
no,
Columbia Heights slash Hilltop area,
no, huh?
That is,
no.
If you're living
yeah,
in Roseville
yeah,
and all
like
those
twins,
surrounding
myself.
Suburbs in
they're
kind
nice
of north central
hey,
St.
What,
Paul,
what do you guys,
remember,
what
please,
of
whatever
recording?
You do, and I can't overemphasize stressing this, do not call, because we've had a
he bought more cassettes this year.
Okay, we're asking the question of the week. Okay, this person bought more cassettes.
Yes,
how many cassettes did you buy this year?
One
cassette. So that means you bought no records
and
no CDs, right? Obviously,
no
unless
CDs,
of course
yeah.
You return some, and then that's a negative one.
He didn't buy no CDs.
Well, I'm mm-hmm. sure probably because he doesn't
want
a CD player.
Do you want me to see
player.
Your name in here? Okay, this is Craig Smith.
Craig Smith is on the phone here. He
and
bought one
this is Andy and Tony
cassette.
Smith's brother. Andy and Tony Smith's brother. They go to the Heights School. They're sophomores and they're twins.
Is that right?
Yeah.
You mean exactly
they're
alike?
Exactly alike. You
really?
Get mixed up,
you
yep.
can't. You can't tell
him.
One from another. Can't
yeah.
tell a player without a scorecard.
Well, one wears glasses, don't they?
Oh, well,
yeah,
they're
one wears
almost
glasses,
twins. Not exactly twins.
Wears
In fact, it's a pretty good place contacts. For twins. You know, Minneapolis, St. Paul. Get it, twins. It's not an original one, but then again,
okay, bye-bye.
Sometimes
he's gonna call back later.
He's gonna call back later.
Yes,
okay.
Yes.
By the way, why don't we get over to the questions real yeah, quick, just yeah. to review
who
them?
Are you?
Okay, yeah, one of our crack crew was just here, and he just ran into the control room. Thank you very much. Okay, question number one is, in what city is Bazooka Bubblegum Maiden?
Yes, this
what
is
city?
Ray's brother.
Okay, Ray's brother's on the phone here. Question number two, quickly, in what year was the first street cleaning machine used? Question number three, and this is a question that a few people tried to guess, unfortunately, not very successful. Is what is the longest running TV series still on the air to this very day?
Can you hear Ray?
I can
hear Ray.
You okay?
By the way, it would also help if you kind of spoke up too, you know. I mean, after all, you know, our mics here, even though that they're probably the greatest mic in the world, and because it's mine, you know, I can't really criticize anyone else's equipment here. Okay, we got Ray. Okay, what do we have on the phone again?
My brother.
Oh, your brother. Okay, Ray's, what is your brother's name?
What's your brother's name?
Unless, of course, just first
Jason.
Name.
Jason.
Okay, he just called a few moments ago, didn't he?
No,
that was my
brother.
Her
brother.
Oh, that was
her
okay,
brother.
That was your other brother. I get everybody's brother. Who knows? Maybe my brother will call. I don't know. But anyway, Jason, that is Ray's brother, bought
just
more
like,
cassettes.
Just like one of those 50s things, you know, you go, blue moon.
In fact, that is a 1950s mic. Yes.
Is it really?
Yes, that is an authentic 1956.
You know,
this is
a antique.
Yes, that is an antique. In fact. Okay, I'm sorry.
He bought five cassettes.
He bought
five cassettes.
Ray's brother Jason bought five cassettes this year.
How many
records did you buy this year? One record and how many CDs? Compact discs for all you greenhorns out there.
No CDs,
obviously, because he doesn't own a player, right?
We do.
Oh, you do own a CD player?
Yeah.
I'll be, and how many CDs do you have in your collection? Not necessarily how much you bought this year. You don't know, but you've got some at least.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. It would be a shame that if you own a CD player, you didn't own any CDs. Then again, I own some type of videotape.
You didn't give me a cake, did you?
What's that?
You didn't give me a cake.
Did I give you? Well, I'll tell you what I'm going to give you toward the end of the show, so you're going to have to be patient.
Oh, okay, sorry.
And I promise, I will not take it back from you.
Oh, okay.
Please call. If she doesn't tell me, watch us. Bye.
Okay, 5720618 is our telephone number. We are taking your phone calls for you people living in Columbia Heights and the community of Hilltop. We can't forget Hilltop out there. It's a community that, in fact, is small.
Who are you?
Okay. It's my brother, Jason.
Hi, Jason.
Okay, we got Lisa's brother, Jason.
Are both of your brothers named Jason?
Just out of curiosity. Is that a coincidence, or are you just putting me on?
No, that's
it's a coincidence, right? Okay, we got Lisa's brother, this type of Jason, on right now, so we don't have anybody confused out here. 5720618, that is our telephone number.
Though.
We are asking you, the folks at home, what type of recordings have
you purchased this year? I got a question.
Okay, Dye's got a question. Go ahead, Dye.
Now, we have a phone at home like this, and we were just curious.
Yeah.
What does the asterisk mark and the tic-tac-toe sign mean on your telephone?
Okay, what that means is that is primarily used not so much for making regular telephone calls. Let's say you belong to a bank that has a sophisticated telephone computer equipment.
1850.
Don't reveal the answer. We mustn't reveal the answer. Here, if you want, I'll write it down for you. Okay.
Down.
There. That's. I hope you can read that. Okay. That's
down.
What the answer is. Okay. Is that okay? Is that okay? Is someone guessing that question as far as what year was the first street cleaning machine introduced? is that the question that you're answering?
Okay, listen.
I don't know what's going on. I haven't been on the phone most of this evening here. It's obvious. So I'm just kind of relying on my guests here, Di, and Lisa, and Ray. By the way, that's Di. Lisa's in the middle. She's wearing the yellow sweater, and Ray is kind of sitting at the other end. Of course, this is what do you do? What'd you do out there? Okay, while they're debating if that's the right answer there, we want to know for you folks at home here, how many types of recordings have you purchased? Have you purchased more cassettes?
Okay, now what is the asterisk and the tic-tac-toe?
Okay, we're getting back to the question. Okay, now let's say if you belong to a bank that uses a sophisticated computer system.
Okay,
your brother Jason is on the phone here. Okay, we'll get to your question in a moment, Dad. Okay, now what question are you? Lisa's brother Jason answering?
He's answering.
Which one? Because we want to know if you might have the right answer, but they're the wrong question.
Street cleaning machine used.
Okay, we're having question number two. And what year was the first street cleaning machine used? And what year are you guessing, Jason?
1854.
You're guessing is that his guess?
Yeah, that's what he said.
He said 1854.
Yeah.
Well, 1854, believe it or not, is absolutely correct.
All right.
Yes, 1854 was the year that the first street cleaning machine was used.
It's Jason.
And Jason.
Iglesia.
How do you spell it?
I-G.
I'm sure, Jason, you want to see what your price is.
Is that
Jason,
is that
you want to see his price? You want to
see
his price?
Italian.
Okay, Jason, we got a prize for you. And of course, we've had a lot of requests for posters, and by golly, we are giving some posters away. And we've got a poster for a movie that was out just briefly last fall. In fact, you first heard about it on this very same program here. It's a movie that stars, of course, Howie Mandel and, I should know this, Ted Danson, and the movie is
A Fine Mess.
Yes. Yes, that's what the poster
I
looks like.
One.
Yes, that's the poster that we're giving away.
Too?
And of course, the poster is courtesy of the folks over at Columbia Pictures.
Hey, Rich,
and
Accessibly.
Do you get a poster? In fact, we'll give you some prize.
Here he is.
Okay, Jason, by the way, Jason, just to give you
who is it?
If you want to pick up your prize, it will be waiting for you starting tomorrow. You have to come over here to the Group
Nancy.
W Studios here in Columbia Heights. We're on Central Avenue right behind Pier 1 Imports. Just come out here during normal business hours, 9 a.m. Monday through
Thank
Friday.
Thank you, Mr. Chase.
And just
Thank
ask
you.
For Eddie or Mary. They're the kind of the people
Mr.
behind
Chase.
The scenes. Just say, gimme, gimme, gimme,
Joe?
And we will give you what's coming to you.
Joe,
okay?
Chase, Mr. Chase is on the top of my list. You're still up there, Mr. Chase.
Is that who's on the phone, Mr.
Her brother,
Chase?
Her dad.
Oh, her dad.
Yes, her dad.
Boy, we're getting a lot of calls out
he's
here.
He's watching it, Sam.
Tell him he's on the top of my list, right up there.
What?
Okay, I'm embarrassing you guys. I'm sorry.
Well, we gotta let you go. There's somebody on the line.
Yes,
okay,
bye.
Thanks.
On the line here.
Did you put his name on there?
Yeah. We got his name. Jason, your prize is waiting for you starting tomorrow. In fact, I'll tell you, because of the Thanksgiving holiday, you have until, in fact, we're going to even give you a little bit of amnesty. You have until the next Thursday, which would be December 4, to pick up your prize. I know next week
Shelly.
Busy as anything. Everybody and their Uncle Louie is going to be up to their you-know-what in activities and things like that. And because we want you to meet your schedule, we're going to give you at least an additional week to pick up your prize.
Do you guys sister name Rhonda?
Who do we have on the phone, first of all?
Steve
we don't even
McDonald.
Know who we have on the phone here. Who do we have
Steve
on the phone?
McDonald.
Steve McDonald.
Oh,
on the
McDonald.
Phone?
Just kidding.
Hey,
kidding.
Steve, what's going on? Hey, ask Steve how many types of recordings did he buy?
What does this mean? What does this mean?
Okay.
What's that sound?
Well, we'll get into
that.
This because you got a
beep on
the line.
That's a call waiting there.
What was it about?
Now, get back to original Di's question. Now, she's asking us, in case you folks at home just tuned in. Now, if you own a touch-tone telephone, now, you see the row of buttons, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on and so forth. Well, on most newer touch-tone phones,
Five cassettes he got.
He has five cassettes.
Yeah.
He bought five cassettes this year, or he owns five cassettes. There's
you
a difference.
Own or buy.
Now, we're asking people, how much did you buy this year? That is 1986.
He bought five cassettes.
You bought five cassettes. How many records did you buy?
How many records? Zero records.
You bought no records and no compact discs, right? So you bought five cassettes this year. And how many cassettes do you own in your collection in comparison to records or possibly discs? What are you doing? There's no speaker on that.
He doesn't own any.
He doesn't own any what?
Records or CDs.
You own no records or you don't own CDs. You're just a cassette person, right? Just a cassette person.
Yep.
Okay, that sounds terrific. Hey, listen, why don't you ask him while he's on if he wants to try any of our questions here.
Do you want to try any of our
We've got
questions?
Two questions here that have not been answered. They're up for grabs. If you want to try them, by all means, you know our magic number, 572-5740. What question does he want to try? He doesn't want to try any questions. Okay, now getting back to Di's question. Now, she asked me that on a touchtone telephone, if you look on the lower left...
Mrs. Cummings.
Oh, hi!
We have Mrs. Cummings on
the phone. Oh, my goodness,
this
is my math teacher.
Well, Di's math teacher, Mrs. Cummings, is on the telephone. Hello, Mrs. Cummings.
Just ignore that sound.
Glad you call us here. Yes,
I look great?
Ignore that.
Thanks.
What about us?
Yeah, what about us? Don't we look good? We want to see ourselves in a lady's beauty.
We all look great.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, she said thank you.
Hey, you're sweet.
Have you been really? She buys cassettes, Miss Cummings does.
You bought more cassettes this year compared to records or compact discs.
Yep.
How many cassettes did you buy this year?
And so does her daughter.
And her daughter buys more cassettes. How many combined, that is you and your daughter, how many cassettes have you purchased this year so far? You got to keep in mind that this year is not over yet, so we've
45.
You bought 45
altogether.
Cassettes?
Yeah, all together.
Oh, combined.
Uh-huh.
How many records did you purchase, if any? Or any discs, for that matter?
A dozen.
You bought a dozen records or discs?
They weren't available on tape.
Oh, that's why you bought the records, just because you couldn't get a cassette version of them.
Panface hasn't called. She don't know none of the answers.
You don't know her questions. You don't know any of them? You want to try them just for laughs? You don't get penalized if you get them wrong. It's not
I love Lucy for the longest.
Okay, you're guessing the third question right here. And what is the longest-running TV series still on the air to this very day? And you're saying I Love Lucy?
MASH.
Well, somebody guessed MASH. Remember, it's wrong. Don't think that if somebody gives an answer to a question, we say it's wrong, and if you try to give that same answer, it's going to be right. We don't play like that. In fact, I don't think anybody plays like that.
They went out to dinner, so they missed it.
Oh, okay, okay.
She's my math teacher here, people.
Yes, yes. Be kind to your math teacher, because If you're not, they can flunk you. Yes, I know what you mean. In fact,
she'd never do something like that, would she? No.
Oh, of course you wouldn't do anything like that. You're not like my math teacher, which I'm not going to get into. So that's okay. She is not watching.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. She's a competing cable company. Okay, first.
Okay, what is this asterisk and what does this mean?
Okay, now. What Di's trying to ask me, and we're going to get over this as quickly as possible. Now, if you're looking at a touch-tone telephone.
Barb is on the phone.
Hello, Barb. Okay, now getting back to Di's question. Now, on a touch-tone telephone, on the lower left and right-hand side of the row of nine buttons, you have a little asterisk and you have a little tic-tac-toe figure. Well, what that's basically used for is it gives out a special tone that some computer telephone systems can recognize.
Who is it?
You know, that is that if you, let's say if you do your banking by telephone, and they ask you, or at least a computer asks you to punch in your account number,
Jim?
Sometimes what they will do is, a telephone call for me?
Jim.
Hey, okay, Jim. Jim, am I speaking to Jim? Hey, Jim, what's going on? Oh, not much here. Hey, Jim, as you probably know that we have some guests here. Di is right here sitting next to me. Lisa is right, and the person wearing the yellow sweater there. Say hi to the folks at home, Lisa, just so in case people just tuned in. Hi. And we have Ray right here in the far, okay.
Give my baby.
Anyway, we're asking you and anyone else for that matter, what type of recordings have you purchased more of this year, either records, cassettes, or compact discs? A-tracks. You still buy A-tracks?
My brother buys those.
And you also buy Leisure Suits and Mood Rings. Sir, I don't really want to disappoint you, but have you ever looked on a calendar lately?
What are Mood Rings?
Is this 1972? Don't we... You don't know what Mood Rings are, Di?
Mm-mm.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, you're having a Sweet 16 party here. Okay, well, anyway... Lime Green... sir, I don't really want to disappoint you, but one of these days, when you ever get around to getting out of your cave,
I
should say that this is 1986, and unfortunately, Mood Rings and Leisure Suits and Pet Rocks and Hula Hoops and all that other good stuff is what they, shall we say, old hat. In other words...
It's not in no more.
You got one of those old hats, too, yes. In fact, I'll tell you what, sir. Why don't you hold on to all of those things and wait about a couple of years, and I am sure that they're going to be in again. Yes, they're going to be coming back. In fact,
pretty soon.
Yes, I bet you Nickel will be coming back in about a couple of years. So in the meantime, fill up your hope chest with all that stuff, and once that stuff comes in, you're going to be the first kid on your block to practically make the pages of GQ and all that good stuff. Hey, listen, while we have you on the phone, do you want to try any of our questions? We have two questions here, not been tapped yet. Okay, and the questions that have not been tapped are follows. In what
got
city...
Got 2 minutes.
Are you kidding me? 2 minutes? Okay. You're right. 2 minutes. Okay, quickly. What city is Bazooka made in? Toledo, Ohio. Well, unfortunately, Toledo, Ohio is not the correct answer. Okay, Wild Kingdom, as far as the longest running TV series. Good guess, but it's an incorrect guess. Okay, Jim. Well, Jim, we'd love to chat, but unfortunately, the time is a-flying, okay? Well, thanks a lot for calling here. Okay, well, anyway, I'm going to have to stop making the phone calls right here, and we're going to reveal the answers because the old clock on the cell wall says it's time to split.
Oh, I mixed up the
okay,
time.
That's okay. Now, the answer to this question here, I'm going to have to reveal the answer here for what city's Bazooka made in, and that's in Duray, Pennsylvania, D-U-R-Y-E-A. You can look that up in your map to see where that is. I think it's near Philadelphia.
Shoot, little division sign.
And question number three, as far as what is the longest running TV series, it premiered on this day back in 1947, and that is Meet the Press. Well, anyway, the old clock and cell wall says it's time to split. We've had a lot of fun. Di, Ray, and Lisa right here. And before we go, I do want to say my special hellos to some people watching out there. Especially, I want to say hi to Doris. She's living in Wisconsin. She's watching this program on a tape delay. Doris, hey, how you doing? And everybody here says hi. Well, anyway, it's been fun. It's been real. Let's put on the end credits and let's say goodbye, good luck. And by the way, next week, because it's Thanksgiving, we will not
my
be on
birthday
the air
today.
Yes, Di is having a birthday. Happy birthday. Let's get out of here quick. Let's go. Bye.